Hello again from Mary's Field. Bill Pfeiffer speaking. Good to be with you. Do press the subscribe button. Good day. It's a good day. Mary's Field, always good news, always something that will touch your head, your heart, help you to grow in some way. The following story is funny. I bumped into it three times in the last year, used by Matt Kelly, the award-winning New York Times author. Used it in the beginning of one of his books. I see it here in a book that was written by Basil Pennington many, many years ago. And I saw it somewhere else. And so it's a good story, and people like it because it teaches a beautiful truth. So I just like to share that with you here from Basil Pennington. I wrote to Basil, 40 years ago, and got a nice letter back from Basil Pennington. Is a Trappist monk. He was connected with the St. Joseph's Abbey in Spencer, Massachusetts. And I remember writing to him and getting a nice letter back from him. And then we were quite shocked, both Cindy and me, Basil was in a car accident going to the dentist or something from the monastery, and ended up in the hospital and never did get out of the hospital. He died. And a wonderful guy. Right here you can see his picture. He's a very happy, very peaceful, wonderful, wonderful guy. Wonderful writing, a writer, and he wrote this book, Center Living, and I read this, must have been 45 years ago, but at the bottom back of it is this story that I'd like to share with you. There once was a holy bishop who was sailing through the South Seas. As the ship approached a small island, the crew told the bishop that three hermits lived there, cut off from most of all human contact. The pastoral heart of the bishop reached out to his brothers. He asked the captain to stop the ship so one of the men could row him ashore to visit the three hermits. The bishop quickly found the three close to their little hut, but was edified by their poverty and simplicity. Their life seemed truly worthy of monks. As he blessed them and was about to take his leave, he asked them to pray the Lord's Prayer with him. The three replied that they did not know the Lord's Prayer. The bishop was taken aback. How do you pray? The three lined up in front of their hut and began, "We are three, you are three, praise God." The bishop was shocked. He begged the sailors to that he could stay a little bit longer, and set about teaching the monks the Lord's Prayer. After more than a bit of time, for they were slow, albeit willing learners, he had the joy of hearing them recite the prayer with him. He blessed them and took his leave. When he got back to the boat, the bishop sat in his room pondering this wonderful experience. Monks who did not even know the Lord's Prayer, however, and that puzzled him. Suddenly, there was a pounding on his door. An excited sailor burst in and shouted that he must come to the deck at once. As he pushed through the crew, the bishop saw the cause of all the excitement. There, running swiftly across the water and now catching up to the ship, were his three hermits. "Bishop, Bishop," they cried, "come back and teach us. We're still not real comfortable with the Lord's Prayer. We've forgotten much of what you taught us." "My son," said the bishop, leaning over the rail, "go back in peace and pray as you can, for the Lord is your God. We are three, you are three, praise God." Beautiful story, a story of the importance of remaining simple before God, even in our prayer life. You know, if you have a loving and fruitful relationship or way of praying with God, and your spiritual life is really truly vibrant and firm and growing, let no one take that away from you. No bishop, no saint, no Bill Pfeiffer. You just keep on going. If your spiritual life is firm and you have a happy and a wonderful relationship with the Lord, just keep that growing. If it's firm and growing, we want to keep putting water on it and make sure that it does keep growing. keep it simple. I used to say to the kids in school, K-I-S-S, keep it simple, stupid. We complicate everything. And centering prayer is most simple. We've talked about that, and it's a good form of prayer. It demands total simplicity, just being present before the Lord. No thoughts, no feelings, no emotions, no imagination, no great wisdom. Just being there with Him, or with the Holy Spirit, or with the Father, or with the whole Trinity, just in total simplicity and allowing God to do whatever God wants to do in your heart and soul. If you're interested in centering prayer, you can check online with Cynthia Brugot or Thomas Keating, or you can check the podcast. We did about 4 or 5 podcasts that were devoted to centering prayer, and you'll find there some of the simple outline and some suggestions about centering prayer. Good to be with you always. Keep it simple. We are three. You are three. Praise God. Boy, if you can do that. The Russian monks always talk about being terribly simple. Just backing off, allowing God to be God and present inside of you. Happiness tomorrow always begins by doing the truth today. Good to be with you. Keep me in your prayers. Know that you're always in mine. Have a wonderful day.